In this video, we'll discuss about stop and wait protocol. Before discussing this C programming, first we'll know what is the concept behind stop and wait protocol. In this diagram, it is clear that sender is sending a data to receiver. As soon as this data is received by the receiver, send the acknowledgement regarding this data has been received properly. If this data is not received properly, if it is corrupted, it will send negative acknowledgement information. As soon as this sender receives negative acknowledgement, once again it will retransmit that same data once again. So here in this case, we'll get some of the difficulties. What are these difficulties? First one is that sender will send the data. During transmission, if this data is lost, if it is not received by the receiver, then receiver will not send any acknowledgement information. It may be negative acknowledgement or it may be positive acknowledgement. It will not send any acknowledgement informations to sender. In that case, what this sender do? It will wait for particular interval of time. Within that interval of time, it has to receive acknowledgement information. If it don't receive any acknowledgement within that particular interval of time, then it will retransmit that same data once again. And another difficulty is that sender send the packet to receiver. This packet has been, or this data has been received properly, and receiver has sent the acknowledgement, but this acknowledgement has been damaged and this acknowledgement has not been received at the sender end. Then sender will wait for particular interval of time after this data has been sent. Within that interval, it has to receive acknowledgement. If it don't receive any acknowledgement, means once again it will resend that same data. Fine. In order to implement this one, we have written some C programming which implements this stop and wait protocol. Initially, we have defined some of the headers. Next, void main int I, j, number of frames. We'll use some of the intermediate variables x, comma x1, x2. Next, another variable, that is number of frames, that is 10. Next, I equal to 1, j equal to 1. We'll define these variables because we are using these variables. Printf, number of frame each. Let us consider that I am sending total 10 number of frames. For all these frames, I want to get the acknowledgement. First, I will send first frame. As soon as I receive the acknowledgement for first frame, next I will send next frame. Like this, total I will send 10 frames, one after another. While, getch, while number of frame, that is 10, 10 is greater than 0, sending frame each. Let's consider this is the 10th frame. Next, I will send 9th frame. Like that, I can send. Sending 10th frame. X equal to random function %10 means in this X, you are storing remainder. Here, what this random do? It will generate the random number. That random number is divided by 10. Then, after this division, whatever the remainder will get, that remainder will be stored in X. So how it will do? We'll get the remainder x. How? Random function divided by 10. Let us consider that random number has generated one random number, that is 123. 123 by 10, we will get a remainder as 1. So 123 by 10, actually this answer is 12, but here you will get a remainder as a 3. This r will be 3. This 3 is nothing but remainder. So x is of what? 3. So here, after this function, whatever the value of x that is generated, na, that will be present in between 0 to 9. So next we'll see, if you get a remainder as a 0, then we can observe that whenever you will get a remainder as a 0 means here receiver is not sent acknowledgement to the sender. So sender need to retransmit that same packet once again whenever remainder is 0. We have said that constraint here. So here let us consider that in one of the cases you may get a remainder as a 0. So 0 divided by 10, you will get answer as a 0. So remainder will be 0, means acknowledgement is not received properly. So what the sender need to do, it need to retransmit that same packet. So how it will do? For x2, I have defined x2 as 1. x2, that is 1, 1 is less than 2. Printf waiting for 1 second. Means if it will not receive any acknowledgement, then sender will wait for some interval of time. After that, it will resend that same packet once. Sleep for 1 second. Next, sending frame is 1. Next, x will be remainder percentage 10. So x will be what? It may be any number in between 0 to 9. If it is in between 1 to 9, apart from 0, means acknowledgement is received. So if this acknowledgement is not received, means once again the same loop get executed. Next, you will send that same frame once again. If you don't get a x value as 0 means, then what it will display? Acknowledgement for frame, this means acknowledgement for 10th frame, acknowledgement for frame number 9, acknowledgement for frame 7, 8, 3, 2, 1 you will get. Number of frame equal to 10 minus 1, you will get 9. Like this, this loop get continues, then you will get a remainder for all the three cases. So we'll see how we can perform. Result analysis for this. Number of frame is 10. Total you are sending 10 frame. Next, let's consider that you have sent first frame, acknowledgement for first frame, acknowledgement for second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Here x is calculated everywhere. If x is of any number in between 1 to 9, it represents that this packet has been arrived at the sender end properly. If you get any x number apart from this 1 to 9, if you get it as a 0, means this frame is not received properly. Acknowledgement for 8, 9, 10, like this, it is the end of stop and wait protocol. Like this, we can analyze this result. This is the end of stop and wait protocol. This is the result analysis. Thank you.